Oh gosh, you guys, I'm so exhausted. I want to do a video really quick though. I have one I still need to edit for this channel. Seems kind of dark in here. Okay guys, Soulja Girl. Oh my gosh, I feel so exhausted right now. Like I just got back from a run and I am so fucking exhausted. Like I did 6 miles, I've been trying to do 6 miles. That's my goal. My goal has been to increase my runs. I was doing four for a while. I've been doing four. And so my goal was to increase my miles to six. I remember back when I was doing 6 miles a day, most days, 6 days a week, I was doing 6 miles. And I was doing it on my lunch break at work. And so now it's like, I'm trying to get back to that point of conditioning. And so, yes, I just got back from a 6 mile run right now. And I'm exhausted. At the same time, I feel so fucking excited too. And I feel so like amped because I did it, you know? And so I'm here today to encourage you guys to stay consistent. Know that every day it will not be easy. In fact, every day will probably be hard for a lot of you guys. Just know that if you are consistent and you stay focused and you're determined, you will reach your goal. Period. You have to believe in yourself and have faith in yourself that you can do it, that you will accomplish your goals. Because a lot of times we don't give ourselves credit as individuals. We don't give ourselves enough credit, period. We focus so much on all of the negative things and all of the what we can't accomplish and what we can't do that we never really sit down and focus on what we can accomplish and what we have accomplished. I also encourage you guys to challenge yourself, because without challenges, we never know what we can accomplish. You know, it's like if I had never like attempted to run 6 miles, I would have never done it, you know, and I would have never known that I could do it, you know. And I mean, that goes with every aspect of our lives when you really think about it. If you don't challenge yourself, you never know what you can accomplish. And I feel like with challenges comes accomplishment. It comes strength. There's just so much that comes with that, you know. Like for me, I mean, I started off lifting some little rinky-dinky 5-pound dumbbells, and I'm up to 45s now. If I had never challenged myself, you guys, I would have never done that. I would never be where I am now, you know what I'm saying, if I had never challenged myself. I mean, even when it came to me getting my house, I've had this house for almost 9 years now. And I remember back when I was renting, and I would tell myself, oh, I'm never going to have a house. I'm never going to be a homeowner. You know, I had to start believing in myself and, you know, even challenging myself to say, you know what, my credit is not the best. You know, but you know what? I can get it to where it needs to be so that I can be a homeowner, you know? And that's what I did. So challenge yourself, you guys, because again, if you do not challenge yourself, you will never know what you can accomplish. So I'm excited right now. Everybody is still asleep, so I'm really trying not to be too loud down here, because like literally everybody is still asleep right now. Got up early this morning. And I got out there and I got the run down. And I feel good about it. I don't have the best time right now. I am not going to lie. I don't have the best time right now. In fact, my time is probably just under 11 minutes, which is a lot for me, because at one point I was doing it in, I want to say, 9 minutes. So I have a lot of improvement and I'm okay with that. And I'm totally up for the challenge. But I'm excited, you guys, no matter how little it's coming out to the camera, I'm super, super stoked right now. My diet hasn't been where it should be. And that is something that I totally have to work on, because I've been doing a little extra lately. And I feel it, you know, I really feel it. I don't do the whole scale thing. You guys know I don't weigh myself. If I can help, I don't weigh myself. And I remember the other day, Joseph, he had jumped on a scale and he was like, here, I don't think your scale is working. You get on there and see what it is so we can see if it's working. I said, don't be trying to put me on the scale. Like, I don't do the whole weigh thing. Only time I weigh myself is when I'm doing some type of fast of some sort. Other than that, I don't weigh myself because I used to be a serial weigher and I would weigh myself every day. There was times that I weigh myself multiple times a day. So in order to get out of that, I started putting my scale like under my bed or in cabinets where I wouldn't see it, because first thing I do when I go in the bathroom is I weigh myself. And so I would allow the scale to just totally like control my life and like determine how I felt about myself. It would determine my self-esteem, my self-worth. I said I have to stop weighing myself, you know, and not allow it to have so much power. And I know a lot of you guys are like that. We allow the scale to have so much power over us and how we feel about ourselves. I used to do that, and I tell myself that it'd be about me feeling good about myself and being comfortable in my own skin and such. And so, but yeah, but I'll leave it there because I don't want to draw this out too long. I'm gonna try to get this edited before Josiah wakes up. I will leave it there. You guys have a beautiful day, night, whenever you're watching. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye, guys.